Thanks for visiting our Pope Francis page here at WTAE.com. I'm Mike Clark. The Pope's trip to Pennsylvania is the highlight of the World Meeting of Families. But for the Archdiocese of Philadelphia, it is so much more. I caught up with Rocco Palmo, the critically acclaimed writer and the creator of the wildly popular blog Whispers in the Loggia, a must-read for church followers all over the world. Rocco told me this trip to his hometown of Philadelphia is designed to renew the Catholic Church.
Again, the question is, what will the Francis effect be? Regardless of how many people are out here, you know, that first Sunday after the visit, will the people who are out here who maybe haven't been to church or aren't even Catholic come into a Catholic church? That's what we're all waiting for, and that's why, you know, $40 to $50 million are being poured into this. There's kind of a disconnect because, you know, folks are all pumped up, everybody's ready to go, you know, Pope is coming, but at the same time, you know, 18% of the people, the registered Catholics in the Archdiocese, are attending Sunday Mass. This isn't a big party, you know, it's, again, the only way the church is going to be rebuilt here is if good people, maybe people who have been away for a long time, come forward, stand up, take on the work. I mean, if it doesn't happen, if that renewal, that spark doesn't happen, this is all going to be a decadent waste. And too many people have worked too hard, and even before that, too many people here have suffered too much for that to be the case. They wanted someone who, especially in light of a secularized Western world, could call people back to the gospel, who could be a compelling, convincing witness of Jesus. Now, the fact this guy's done this without practically a word of English is incredible. And that's the thing, most Americans don't realize that he doesn't speak a word of English, or barely. You're going to see that here because he's going to be speaking mostly in Spanish because it's where he's comfortable and it's what gets people scared. It's where he can go off the cuff. You know, he's doing it. He's coming to a prison here. He's going to meet with the homeless in New York. He's going to feed the poor who come to a soup kitchen in Washington. To say, okay, if I'm the Pope and I can make the time to do this here, you know, what are you, in all of us, in our own lives, what more can we do? And if one person can set the world on fire like this guy has, well, say 10, 15, 20, 100, 500,000 people just step up and do a little more, then this whole society will be a better place.